Hello, JP here, and welcome to my review of the AstrHori 28mm Full Frame Periprobe Lens. AstrHori are an interesting brand. Based in China, they have released a few macro and creative lenses over the years, focusing on both the video and photographic market. In an apparent response to Lauer's original macro probe lens, AstrHori released their own version in both APS-C and full-frame versions. The APS-C version of the probe lens is 18mm at f8 maximum aperture, and their full-frame version is 28mm at f13. Now, AstrHori have recently released their version of the periscope or periprobe lens, a version of the design that has a fixed 90-degree lens, which allows for more dynamic positioning for certain shots, allowing the lens to be a lot closer to the ground or allow the lens itself to be more easily positioned from either above or below. Now, AstrHori have sent us the periprobe-only lens to review. There is a more expensive kit that includes an additional interchangeable straight lens barrel. Depending on the option you buy, you'll either be able to attach the straight barrel, 90-degree periprobe lens, or both. The lens itself has integrated gears for focus and aperture control that are nicely dampened. It also has a USB-C socket for the LED light tip that is surprisingly bright. The top section of the lens is waterproof, which adds the ability to submerge the lens into water or other fluids. The lens barrels attach via a bayonet-style locking collar, which allows four fixed positions of the lens orientation. The locking ring on the AstrHori is pretty well designed, and switching out lenses this way can be done in a matter of seconds. When shooting super macro subjects, it is often very easy to impart unwanted wobble and shake into the footage because of the slight flex that such a long lens will impart onto any camera mount. The best solution is to add an additional lens support to stiffen the mechanical linkage between the lens and the camera. Nitze make a lens support for 15mm rods that is intended for use on the Lauer range of probe lenses. Unfortunately, the diameter of the AstrHori periprobe is slightly wider and won't fit into the Nitze mount. Thankfully, there is a cheap solution. A quick search on AliExpress allowed me to find a handlebar camera mount that will enable the clamp to open wide enough to accept the AstrHori lens. Most importantly, the mount has a centrally recessed quarter-inch thread mount that can be easily used as a replacement clamp for the rest of the Nitze support. The only downside with this one I purchased is that the screw threads can only tighten from underneath, but to be honest, once I replace the bolts with shorter ones, I'll probably just leave this collar fixed to the barrel of the lens, so it's always there if it's needed. We are using this lens on a current project, and the ability to submerge the lens is a huge bonus. We did experience a bit of chromatic aberration on high contrast edges, but nothing that could not be cleaned up a little in post. For the money, and for the creative options that they can unlock for the right project, any image softness or artifacts are somewhat excusable. Once these lenses are closed down to usable stops for miniature work, they usually clean up and get respectfully sharp. As the full frame version of the AstrHori periprobe is 28mm versus the Lauer's 24mm, I came up with a solution to get a horizontal field of view to match, and that is by using a front anamorphic adapter as commonly available for mobile phones. The lens is a fixed focus 1.33 squeeze, which when added to the front of the 28mm probe lens will give us an approximate 24mm horizontal field of view when conformed to the 2:3:9:1 aspect ratio when using a 16:9 sensor camera. Now, I'm not the first one to try this. Matthew Stern did it exactly the same on the original probe lens, and you can check out his video here. I simply adapted the idea to work with the periprobe version. As with his version, you also gain the cinematic lens flares, which is a nice bonus. I think what sets AstrHori lenses apart is the price. They are considerably cheaper than their competition, and for the money, they can deliver extremely similar results, with quite comparable build quality. Now, we have experience with both the Lauer and AstrHori lenses now, and can say that while they may not be the best image quality in strict photographic terms, they more than can deliver for video and film use by offering truly unique perspectives that simply cannot be captured any other way. So, is the lens worth buying? Well, if you're in the market for a probe lens, it'll be crazy not to first check out the range that AstrHori has, especially if you are on a budget. I think they offer very good value for money, and if you know that you may want to explore shooting macro, miniatures, or food photography, I think that the results that you can get from lenses like these can be well worth investigating. Check out the AstrHori website for their current range of products. The link can be found here, or listed in the description text of this video. So, that's it. Please stay tuned for some upcoming episodes where we'll show the results from this lens and some exciting upcoming episodes. If you're still on the fence in terms of buying such a lens like this, maybe first check your local camera rental house, as it's becoming more and more common for these specialist type lenses to be available for daily hire. Maybe you could try before you buy. Just a thought. Till next time, JP, signing off.